Yeah, very good afternoon, you all. And this is the video lecture on web technology. And today in this lecture, we will be covering the topic beyond syllabus for unit 1. And the topic is WML, that is the wireless Markov language. In this wireless Markov language, this is important because we will be using all the things for either the mobiles or we will be using for tablets. That is the mini version of these computers. Okay, all for all these wireless packages, all the wireless devices will be using for these things. Okay, now let us see how we write program for this WML. Just I am opening a program for this one. This is my first program. For this, what I have done, I have gone to the C drive. In the C drive, I have created a folder just WML. You can create any folder name. Because these are WML programs I created and named the program is the folder as WML. Under this WML, I'm writing my first program. This program name is something like that p1.wml. Okay, p1.wml. So now you see it here. So for writing a program on these things, we use special tags like WML. It is similar to the HTML, but here we are using, instead of HTML, we are using WML. Okay. So this WML opening tag, closing tag WML here. So inside the WML, we'll be using the different cards. So okay, this card is just like one instance of this, which will be displayed on your screen. That is the small screen, like your mobile and etc. Okay, so I use the tag card. Here I provide an ID for each and every card. ID is equal to number one and title is equal to card number one. In this paragraph, it is to be displayed hello world. So what you want to write inside the paragraph, same thing will be displayed with the ID number one. Okay, then I create another card, card ID number is equal to 2 and title is equal to card 2. So here I write another paragraph. Welcome to our WAP tutorial. This is the protocol for that one, wireless application protocol. Okay. So this is the protocol for this WML language. Okay. So this is the thing. Now how to run this program? You write this program, you save it, and then you just double click this program. You can see, you can see the output hello world here. Okay, now like this, you can write a number of program here. Just I close this, the first output. Then I go for the second program. Just I open with the Sublime. You can see it here. There I'm directly writing the WML program. Because the WML and XML, the all are compatible. So I'm writing hence onwards all the program in WML, I'm writing inside the XML. Okay, XML, it is the starting in unit 2. I'll be maybe the next class, because today the last class for this unit 1, already 15 days we have covered, 8 to 10 classes we already covered for this one. So in this class, just I'm covering the what I told you, the topic beyond syllabus, TBS I'm putting. So in the second unit, we'll be covering this XML, then I'll explain you the details. But one thing remember, this XML tag, you can write it just the starting tag, that the less than question mark. And just after that, the XML, then version is equal to under double quotation 1.0. Then the end of this XML is just like a question mark and just the greater than sign. So this is the one line. From this line, the browser will understand that it is a XML program. Okay. So these are things, and the remaining two lines are also the similar type things. You are using doc type, that it will understand that you are using a part of this HTML. And all things are there by default. There is nothing to understand, nothing to write. It is just what they are using by default. I am using it here. Okay. So this is the DTD. It is also compatible with the DTD and WML version 1.10. But XML version 1.0 is compatible with this one. For writing this program, similar type. I am using WML, the tag, opening tag and the closing tag WML. I am using card. Title is the paragraph. In the first paragraph, I am writing. This is a paragraph. Under the opening tag and closing tag P. In the second paragraph I'm writing, this is another paragraph and a line break with a line break. I'm writing it here, okay? So then I save it and try to run this program also. This is my program number 2. When I double click here, you can see the output. The output is coming, this is a paragraph and this is another paragraph with a line break. It is coming the second line, okay? So this is how we write the WML program and how it runs. The thing is that where it runs. So it is not like it is not running your on your browser. It is not just like the HTML. So I need to install another thing. It is just like this. I will show you on the desktop. We are having program like this. You can see it here. I am using WinWAP. WinWAP for Windows, the version is 4.2 I am using. Okay. You need to download this one. You have to install in your system. And then you can, whatever the program you are running, when you are saving with WML, the icon will be appearing like this. Okay. And the file will be saved like this. When you double click this file, automatically it will run. Another way is that we can go for this WinWAP, that is the smartphone browser, it is also there. Here, that one also I have one point some version, it is also there. So it will appear like this. When I double click, it will appear like this. Now it is opening for you. Maybe within some seconds it will open. Once it opens, we can, whatever the program you are writing there, the same thing also you can see it here. But here till now I am unable to configure. You can use Nokia browser version 4.0. We can use Sony Ericsson, something like it has opened now. So suppose I want to go for menu. So this is the menu, but here we cannot click it here. So you click this button. So you go to the command for going up and down. You are having this button is up and this button is down. And this is right and left. So I go for this. Then I go for the setting. Then for clicking OK, then I put this one also. Then you find it here. Because I'm not going through a proxy, I'm using Wi-Fi of my own system here. So I'm using direct, and you press it OK or you pick it cancel. So I'm putting it cancel because it is not configured till now. And for closing all the things, you can, how you are using the red button of your mobile to close all the things, I press it one and it goes out. Okay. Now two methods I've shown you. One is using this WinWAP software that you can download. Don't confuse, it will be 32 version, it will work both in 64 as well as the 32. 64 version is not available for you. Okay. Then another thing is that I told that WinWAP smartphone, that also you can do, or you can go for the Nokia browser that is 4.0 for the smartphone, as well as the Sony Ericsson. For different it is there, but you have to download, you have to configure, then only it will work. For this, what you need? You need one of the servers. Either you have to go for the internet IIA server or the Apache server you have to configure. Then you have to go for another thing. Three softwares you need for that one, okay? So initially, if you want, I can show you here also. Something here I will show you here. This is the content, how you'll be using. So you need all the things. You need a WAP-enabled web browser. So WAP-enabled, either you can make it the Apache by Microsoft, or you can use the Apache or Microsoft using by default, that is the IIS server. So I can, you have to enable either the IIS or you have to go for the Apache. Any of the server you have to install and configure. Then you have to go for a WAP gateway, that is the simulator, you needed that one. Because either you need a physical device to do all the things, otherwise you go for a virtual, that you throw a simulator, you can simulate. There is difference between the emulator and simulator. Emulator is the bigger one, and you can go for the entire things, but small part is the simulator, you can use this simulator to do all the things. So and then another is the WAP phone simulator, you can go for the Nokia, or you can go for the Sony Ericsson. So all the things you have to download, you have to install, you have to configure. Then whatever the program you are running, the same output you can also see in your virtual mobile. Okay, that is the thing. That is till now I have not implemented that one. Still I am trying. When it is successful, I will show you. Okay. Now let us come to our program. Program one successful, you have shown. Then I am going for the program two also. We have shown you. If you want to see the output of this program two, you can see the output. This is a paragraph. And the second one also, this is a paragraph, then a line break is there with a line break, okay? So this is the content, and this is the program, and this is the output when you run it. Then I go for the program number P3. Then open this program with these things. Now you can see, this is also similar way I have written inside the XML program only. Here I am starting the WML. See, without this XML program also it will run, don't confuse. And because this XML and WML is compatible, so it is more convenient for us to use this one. Then I am using the cut tag, and title is equal to formatting. So here the basic commands of HTML, what we have already implemented in HTML, the same thing I am implementing here for normal. It is normal, go for the line break, BR. It's all these things are inside the paragraph. For italic, you can use either the I or you can use the EM tag. Okay, I am using the EM tag, emphasized. Again, EM, closing tag EM, then go for a line break BR, then you go for the strong, it is just for bold, then close the strong and go for a line break, then bold, then similarly the italics, then underlining, then the big font and the small font. So all the things you can do, and you can very much do using all the things. Now I save it and run this program number 3. You can see the output. The output is coming like this. So this is the normal font, and this is the italic, emphasize what I told you, that this is some strong, this is bold, this is italic, this is underline, this is big, this font is bigger than this normal font, and this is smaller than the normal font. So all these things you can practice what you have done in HTML, and I have done it here also. This is the example I have shown you. Then we are going to the program number 4. In the program number 4, you can see it is a program how to create a table with this mobile. Okay, what you need to do, you write the same WML tag, and you take the char tag. With the char tag, you the title is your table. And for creating a table inside the paragraph P, I am writing the tag table, and the number of columns I am using 3. So number of lines I am using 2. First one is the table heading, second one the table data. In the table heading, I am writing serial number, branch 1 and branch 2. Then the table data, I am writing serial number is 1, branch number 1, that is CSE, and the branch number 2 is AIDS. So I congratulate all the students that the Department of Computer Science, it already got the approval for this artificial intelligence and data science. So in the coming semester, in the first year, we'll having a branch like AIDS. I welcome you, and I request you all, you also involve, and you encourage for admission for students. This is a specialized branch, and there is a lot of demand for this AIDS. Okay, so this is the table head, and this is the table data, and I close the TR here. I close the table, I close the paragraph, close the cut, and close the WML. So now let us see whether you are able to create a. Now one question comes, will border will come here? No border will come, because we have not created a border for these things. If you want to be a border to be there, then you have to write the coding what you have written in your HTML. Okay, now I go for this running of this program 4, and you can see the output here. So it is not exactly looking like a table, but tabular data is there. The serial number, it is 1, branch 1 is CSE, and also the branch 2 is AI and some data science. Okay, so this is how you can create a table. Then I go for our next program, that is program number 5. Then I first show you the coding, then I will explain you. Here I am trying to create a link. So for this link, there are 2 ways. Using this anchor tag, anchor, you can do, or using the tag also you can do. So if you want to use whatever you do, under this WML, you have to use the card tag. So under this card tag, your title, you put it, whatever tag you want to put it, whatever the title you want to put it there. Then you write a paragraph, close the paragraph here. Then you create a tag anchor and close the tag anchor. Inside this anchor, so what will be there? What is the name of your link? Name of the link, it is just the next page. It is there. So control Z, I put it here, next page. Now, here I am using go tag. So it is similar to the A. So go, H reference, where it is there? So I have created another page. The page is test.wml. So you can see, I have created another page, that is test.wml. That reference I am giving it here. When you click on this next page, what is the content of this text.wml, it will appear here. Okay, now this is there. Now I go for this one. If you remember, this is the program number 5. I run this program number 5, and you can see, yeah, it is coming a link, that is the next page. When I click on this next page, it is showing the content of which content? Content of test.wml. In test.wml, what is the content I have written? The same content it is showing it here. So it is the concept of link, what we have already done in HTML. Same thing also we are able to do it here. Then I'm going to the program number 6. I show you here, then open it, sorry. So page number 6, program number 6, open this program. Here, I'm using the tag A. You see, up to this it is same. So I'm using the inside the P tag, inside the card tag, card title is got a tag, A tag, not A tag. A, you can write it small a also. I can write it small a. This is the A, what I am writing it here, A tag. Okay, so A, H reference, the same test.wml, this is the link, and the next page will be the link name. Then close the tag A, close the tag P, close the tag card, close the tag HTML. Now what you need to do, you just save this program and you run this program. What is the program name? program name is P6, and if I click this program P6, you can clearly see the output is same. I click it here, the output also it is going there. Okay, so we have completed 6 number of programs successfully using that program. Now I am going to the program number 7. Then I am opening this program and I will explain first. Here I am going to insert an image. Okay, for inserting an image, say you have to download an image with WBMP. For WBMP, what you need to do, first you need to download a program. Say suppose I need to download a program, then I have to open this one, go to the Google, then so it is not open. Yeah, so that is very slow. So what you have to write it there, some image dot w, yeah, some image with WBMP, image with WBMP. So what is our things? WBMP. Okay, then I sort that one. So if an image is there, let us see, image with WBMP, it is searching. Once I find a small image, I will be downloading the same image. That some images are here. So I can download, copy image, okay, or better, save the image. Save the image as something, image one dot WBMP under double quotation, and this is there, this is saved in the desktop only. Okay, so now I save it. Okay, I save it here. Now I go to there on the desktop. You can see one image will be there with the extension WBMP. Can you see it here somewhere? Yeah, I don't find this image. Image one, I something. Yeah, this is the thing. Image one, WBMP. Copy this image. So copy and put it inside this folder here. Yeah, create a folder. Create a folder new. This is the folder name is images. Write it caps lock IMAGES under this images folder. Then you double click there and paste it here. Then paste it here. So this is the image 1.wbmp. Okay. So now what I need to do in my program, I need to I put it image 1. Caps lock I images. Okay, control S. I save this program. So I now everything is okay. That is the program number 7. I go to the program number 7. Yeah, I go to the program number 7 and try to run this one. Still it is not coming. Maybe that program what I downloaded is not the image. Maybe that is the reason it is showing some problem. Reload this one. Okay. So what you need to do, you have to download a special file. What is the extension of that one? No, this is not the program. Some image dot image download. Okay, so we go for some images. Net is slow, but still I will be waiting for some images. So this is save image as this is image 1.wmbp WBMP, image 1 dot WBMP, WBMP, yeah, just I double quote here, then I put a double quote here, then SEBI title site is already existing, yes, I want to replace that one. Now, this is already there on the desktop, I think, yeah, it is here on the desktop. Let me see, what is that image, yeah, this is the image, it is there. Now copy this image, now copy this image and put it inside this folder of images, you paste it, yes, replace, okay. Now 4 kilobyte it there, I hope it should come now, but I'm not sure about whether it will come or not. Yeah, so we, yeah, go to the program. Our program was program number 7, if you remember. So I double click here, program number 7. No, still it is not coming. So maybe we are unable to download and save this this particular figure. Okay, p7 dot WML. Okay, so anyway, what you need to do, you download that image and you keep it in the same folder. Same folder where you put it, but I already created these images. P7 also, I can show you the coding. It is same images slash image 1 dot WBMP. WBMP. Okay, so my folder also, it is containing images WBMP. No, this is not saved as the image. It is not saving till now. So that I have to check it, whether it is the, what is that image? Image online convert, no, this is not even the images file format, online convert, oh, okay, any image you have to convert. I am unable to download any image with the WBMP, so I'm trying now. Once I download the image, so I'll be able to show you. This is the thing one there, this one there, this is the icon, okay, online converter. Okay, you provide any image and let us see whether it is able to do that one, okay. So, I am going for online converter, general image to WBMP, after converting that one, then only we'll try to load it here, okay. Now what I need to do, I will convert this image of mine into WBMP and then I will put the same thing here, okay. No, still now it is opening. Internet is very slow, it is very difficult. So anyway, we have some images, suppose my logo is there, this same logo I will convert into WBMP and try to upload there, okay. That I'm trying, but net is very slow, I'm struggling for that one. In the meantime, we can proceed and we can do some other things, okay. So I do not know whether it will open or not. Then what do we need to do? We go for the other program, that means this is not the image. Not the image. No. Okay. Delete. So this is not the proper file. Now we go for our next program, program number 8. Okay. So you can go for the program number 8. Here you see this program. What I am going to do? I am going to provide. What are the objects we created inside this now? Like the tag, like the name, age, sex, all these things input, all the things say text box and the tag, okay. The same thing I am going to do it here. Now you see it here, I started with the WML, with the closing tag WML, then I use the tag name for the input, because for the label directly write it name, input, name is equal to name, size is equal to something you 15 I put it and go for a line break. Then age, input, name, input and name is equal to something, right, you write it age and size is equal to 15 I am giving. So format, just I am putting something like a star n. That means it should come like this n. That's the character. Then I go for the beer. Then I go for the input. Name is equal to sex, size is equal to 15. Now this is how I am creating a form like things inside this WML. Okay. Now you double click this PP8. You'll see, you'll find name. Suppose I write D or I write capsule D, E, R, something like that, whatever you can write it here. So age you can write some 23 years, or sex you can write male, or name you can write Mr. X. Okay, so all the things you can write it here. Okay, this is how we have done using this thing. Okay, next we are going for the 9. You see the coding first in the 9. Here also I am using the other things like the how to create option, like the HTML tutorial, XML tutorial, web tutorial. So I am going for a selection of all the things. So here I'm writing card, title is equal selectable list 1, the paragraph, then select. Under the select tag, then you use the options. How many options are there? You put it. My first option is the HTML tutorial, second option the XML tutorial. One is HTML, then one is XML, then is the web. Okay? So all these tutorials are there. Now this is my program, and the program number is 9. Then I try to run this program number 9, and you can clearly see program number 9. The output is coming like this, and here you can select which one you want. Suppose I write XML, so it is displaying XML. Suppose I write WAP, it is showing WAP. So these are all the practices what you have done in your HTML. Same thing I am trying to do it in WML. Then I am going for the program number 10. In the program number 10, we are doing the same thing, but here you are using another way, selectable list. Tutorial, so the same thing, I think similar output it will come here, don't worry for this thing. Then I am going for program number 11, okay? Program number 11, you is this one. Here I am trying to put just like the title, the price, some information I want to put it in this field, okay? Then for that we need to use the tag field set inside the card, title, field set, okay? I use the tag field set. Inside the field set, I use the title, then the name of that input is the title, and the type is got text. Here the price is also like that. All the things you can put it, how you are writing a label, how you are writing a text box for this showing the data. I will show the output of this program number 11 here. You can see, you go for this P11, okay? Yeah, you can see it here. I put the title. Title is WAP WAP. And what is the price? It is, I write some $50, something like that, okay? So this is the thing it is going to show you, okay? So this is about that one. Then we go for the program number 12. In the program number 12, I am going to show you like this. No, just we are going for something like radio button or some other type of things are there. There also we can use all the things. Input, name, your name, size is equal to 12, option is equal to value is equal to male or value is equal to female, and male, female also will appear there. Then age, input name is equal to age, size is equal to 12, so format is equal to n, like that it is coming, anchor. So I am using the method is get here, you can use both post or get, and age reference I am giving a process.php, because till now you have not done the PHP program, so it will not go there, but it will show the output of all the things. Then post field name it will come, because what is the name I have given, that variable name it will come here, the age will come here, the sex also it will be displayed there, okay? Now, so this is, I am writing inside the go tag, and then the submit data anchor will be there. When you click it there, using this get method, it will go to the process.php file, okay? So this I will explain afterwards, because you do not know PHP right now, and I will be telling you about the methods we are using get and post. Get is visible to all. So and for small amount of data we can use that one, but when more data and confidential data we can use the method, but usually you go for the post method. You are not using only for the study purpose and for demonstration purpose, I am using this get method, okay? Or where the content is not so important, there is no security issue, you can use this get method. It's clear? Now this is the program number 12. So I run this program number 12, and you can see the output here. You can see it here. Yeah, the output it has come like this. So I write the name. Suppose I write Gunamani, yeah, something I write, Gunamani. Yeah, so then sex is male, age I write something 50. Okay, then I submit the data. When I submit the data, it is showing that specified folder is not there. Where? Because it is to be stored in some PHP file that I have not created. Okay, once it is created, all the data will be stored there. It's clear? In this way, you can do all the things. But you see, because I am using this get method, you can see everything is visible here. So name is equal to Gunamani, age is equal to 50 is visible here. If it is a post method, it will not be visible. Clear? This is the difference. So now, I am going for the next program, program number 13. In this program number 13, let us see what is this program. So here, same thing I am doing. It is a big one. It is just like some template. Okay? So here you can use a number of tag. I can go for the do inside the template tag. I can use the do. I can go for go. It is just like a link. Then do name is equal to menu one. So I can create menus. I can create anchors. I can create tags and all the things I can do it here. Then you can use the different cards also here. First one is the template. Then I'm using card one. Okay. Now let us run this program and see what is the output. And from that we'll try to understand what is this program. Okay. Now you go for this program number 13 and you see the output. Yeah, the output is coming here like that. So select the one chapter. Suppose I select chapter number one. Now the chapter one, all the things it is appearing it here. Okay. So this is very much important while you are going for creating web pages. Okay. So in this way you can do. Then you go for this program number 14. Let us see what is the program here. This is also similar type of things. So this is the thing on events, okay? So this is event driven, how to create an event also, this is explained here. So let us run this program and see the output. This is the program number 14. Now you run this, so now go to card 2 and going backward. So all the things you can do it here, okay? So what are the events there? So now I think we have the minimum idea or the minimum knowledge about this wireless or WML, wireless markup language, which mainly will be using for sales, mobile phones, smartphones, this is there. But you can say why the screen is, because I am using WinWAP, So you have to use Nokia browser version 4.0, or you have to use Sony Ericsson, that is for version some T double six one or like that, some person I will share with you. So these are the things you have to use. Then only whatever the output you are seeing in my WinWAP, those you can see using your that one. Okay. Now let me see what is the output here. So still it is trying. Okay, these things I close it here. This thing I close it here. Yeah, it's still struggling. Now let me see whether the one which I tried here, whether it is coming. Yeah, still it is coming. Okay, here also you can try and you can do all the things, but till now it is not configured. So once it is configured, what are the program you are writing WML? So just like our one WAP, one app you can also deploy it here. Okay, so it is still running in the background. Yeah, it has come now. And you can, for clicking this menu, you have to click this button. So for making up and down, you can use this button up, down, this, that, and of all the setting. Okay, then setting. Then you, for clicking yes, it is okay. Then you can see the direct or the HTTP proxy. Because I'm not using any proxy here, I'm using direct Wi-Fi and hotspot also. So that, the things we can use it here. And I think this is the thing, the topic beyond syllabus I covered. So my request to you all, you see this video and you click a like also and subscribe for this also. This is not the regular syllabus, this is the topic beyond syllabus, and it will be more useful and it will be recorded also. It will be recorded for recording purpose. I request you all to provide a like as well as subscribe. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Actually, I was going for some video lectures there, but because of some network program, I was unable to complete that one. So that was a technical problem, it is not a problem from my side. So the same thing I have recorded and shared with you, and thank you for watching this video. And once again, I'm requesting you, please click a like as well as subscribe for these things. Thank you. Thank you for watching for this.